गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट, होप यू माइट हैव डन विद प्रैक्टिस सेट 13 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 एंड आल्सो द एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन व्हिच वर मेंशन टू गिवन टू यू. सो टुडे वी शैल बी लर्निंग अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड HCF एंड LCM ऑफ एनी गिवन नंबर. नाउ इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस यू हैव लर्न टू मेथड टू फाइंड HCF एज वेल एज LCM. फर्स्ट वॉज प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन, सेकेंड वॉज कॉमन डिविजन मेथड. Now it's up to you which method you want to follow. Whichever method you feel easy, so in that method you will solve this HCF and LCM. But as I will advise you, common division method is short and also is easy to do. So let's start. So here first I'll start with the prime factor method. So for that we will make this vertical arrangement and we are going to place this number in. So, and using the divisibility rule, we will start with the division. It will divide by 3. 3 5s are, and 5 is a prime number. So, it will 5 1s are. So, these are the factor of 15. And same way, we are going to start with 16. Vertical arrangement, I am going to place this in. Now, again using divisibility rule, it will divide by 2. We get answer 30. And again, it will divide by 2. We get answer 15, and here it will divide by 3, 3 5s are and 5 1s are. So these are the factor of 60. Now after that, what we did in the previous video? Yes, after finding this factor, we are supposed to list them all together. Now after listing them together, what we are going to find? We are going to find the common factors. So what are the common factors? It's 3 multiplied by 5 here, 3 multiplied by 5 here. So these two are common in both number. So these 3 multiplied by 5 is a common factor. So after finding this common factor, what answer we have got is nothing but the HCF of 15 and 16. So here answer is what? 15. 5, 3 5s are 15. Now to find LCM, what is the additional step I am supposed to do? Yes, it's to find uncommon factor, that is 2 multiplied by 2 is uncommon. Now after finding this common and uncommon, what I am going to do to find LCM, I am going to just multiply them all together. That means 2 multiplied by 2, multiply by 3, multiply by 5. So, multiplying all them together, we get answer as 60. So, therefore, LCM of 15 and 60 is 60. Let's take one more example. Now, here, find HCF and LCM of 32 and 37. Now, here, I am going to do the common division method. Now, as we know that two numbers, so two vertical arrangement I am supposed to do. So, here, I am going to place them in. Now, let's start with the finding common number by which both these number will get divided. But here children, as you can see this 37, 37 is a prime number. That means it will only divide by 1 and itself, means 1 as well as 37 only. It will not divide by any of other numbers. So here what will be the common? That means 32 and 37 will not divide by any of one common number. So what will be the common among them? It will be only 1. That means 132s are, 137s are. Now this is a common factor. 1 only we will get. Why? Because 37 is a prime number. So that means this both will not divide by any common number. Let's compare the same with prime factorization. Now here I'll do the vertical arrangement. And I will use the divisibility rule to find the factor of this 32. So your 32 will get divided by 2 and we will get this all factors like this. Now here 2 5 times is a factor of 32. Now same for 37. 37 is a prime number, that means it will only divide by 37. 37 1s are. So here 37, for factor of 37 is 7, 37 only. Now after that, we are going to list them all together. 37 equals to 37 only. Now, since we do not have any number common, we have already learned that whenever we do not have any number common, factor common, so we are supposed to take it as common 1. Now, what is a common factor? Is 1 over here. Therefore, what would be the HCF of 32 and 37? Is 1. Now, after to find LCM, what I am going to do, I am going to find the uncommon terms. Now here, everything are uncommon. That means 2, 5 times and 37. 2, 5 times and 37, all are uncommon. So together we are going to multiply. And how, what we will get as LCM? Yes, we are going to multiply all together. HCF means it is a common factor and uncommon factor. So, after multiplication, what we are getting here is 1184. Now, here this is the prime factorization method which we have followed. Now, let's see in the common division method how to find HCF as well as LCM. Now, here this is a factor we have done. Now, children, as we know, always remember that whatever we get in the upside arrow, in upside arrow, that is your highest common factor. That means the common factor is your HCF. Now, how to write the LCM? Now, for LCM, what we will do? We are going to consider both L shape, that means upside arrow as well as horizontal way arrow. So, here it is 1. Multiply by 32 as well as 37. So for HCF, we are going to only consider the upside arrow, and for LCM, we are going to consider upside as well as downside arrow. So together multiplication, we get answer 1184. So here, as we can compare here, that to whenever we find the factors, prime factorization, the procedure goes very lengthy, and as we compare in the common division method, the procedure is shorter compared to prime factorization method. So, in whichever method you follow, you get this answer same. Let's move to another example. Here, we are having find HCF of and LCM of 17, 102 and 170. Now here we are having three numbers. So here I am going to only follow the common division method. Now three numbers, so three vertical arrangement. I am going to place them all in. Now after that placing in, I am going to find the common among all this, which will be the number can divide these all three together. So as we can see here, 17 is a prime number which can divide all these three. So 17, 1s are 17, 17, 6 are 102 and 17, 10s are. Now here children, already I have told you in the previous video that whenever we find LCM, we are supposed to check whether if the three numbers are, whether we don't get any common factor, but here as you can see, 6 and 10 can divide by 2. That means I'll have to divide it by 2, and 1 will be as it is and 2 threes are, 2 fives are. That means I'll have to continue the divide till I don't get any common number which divides all three numbers. Okay, now to find HCF and LCM. Now children, here as we can see, this 13 is the only number which can divide all three numbers together. This 17 can only divide these three numbers together. This 2 is only dividing two numbers, not all three numbers. That means only the number which divide all three numbers will be your HCF. The only common factor among all three will be your HCF. Now for LCM, I am going to take all. That means upside arrow as well as the downside arrow, means horizontal arrow. So to find LCM of 17, 102, 117, what I am going to do? I am going to multiply them all together. Multiplication of all this L shape, we will get the answer of LCM. So here, as in ascending order, we are supposed to arrange 2 multiply by 3, multiply by 5, multiply by 17. So what is the answer we will get is 510. So here, children, remember, whenever we write HCF, only the common factor which is common, which can divide all three numbers, that number will be your only HCF. Otherwise, it won't be your HCF. Here, we cannot consider 2 as HCF. Why? Because this 2 is only divisible, these 2 numbers, not 1. So that means this 2 we cannot take it as common factor. Hope you are understanding the concept. Let's take one more example. Now here again we have 3 numbers. 3 vertical arrangement. I am going to place them all in. Now again I will have to find which is the common number can divide all these 3. Now as we will check all these 3, 7 will be the common number which can divide all these 3 numbers. That means 7 3s are 21, 7 7s are 7, 12s are. We get 84. Now here as we can check, 3 and 7 is itself a prime number, but 3 and 12 can divide by 3. That means 3 1s are, 7 will be as it is, 3 4s are. Now again children, you can see here, only 7 is a common number which can divide all these 3. So what would be our HCF? It will be your 7 only. Now what will be your LCM? Yes, this vertical arrangement as well as this down horizontal arrangement will be your LCM. So what we are going to do? We are going to multiply them all together. That means as we are going to arrange them vertically, we will have 3 multiply by 4, multiply by 7, multiply by 7. So what would be the answer is your 588. Hope you are understanding the concept of. Let's take another example.